obligations of paying banks. Under Negotiable Instrument Act 1881, there is a criteria for payment of checks. As per this criteria, what is the obligation of the bank to make payment of checks issued by its customers? Section 31 of NI Act, it fixes responsibility to pay checks issued by customers if certain conditions are satisfied. So banks have obligation under Section 31 to make payment of those checks which are issued by their customers. But this obligation is subject to the condition that they must follow the following conditions. The following conditions must be satisfied. First, signature of the customer must be as per records of the bank. If signatures of the customer are different, then banks have no obligation to make the payment. Second condition is the customer must have sufficient balance in the same account. In the same account, it must not be a different account. So the account from which the check has been issued, it must have sufficient balance at the time of the presentation of the check. And these funds must be properly available for payment of that check only, not for any other purpose. So if there are sufficient balance in the account, then those funds must be meant for payment of that check only, not for any other purpose. Fourth, the presentation of the check must be during business hours. If these four conditions are satisfied, then banks have obligation to make payment of the checks. And in case bank refuses to pay despite compliance of these conditions, the bank is liable to the drawer, that is to the customer, for loss, if any. So if customer complies with these conditions and bank returns that check as unpaid, then bank is liable to the drawer for loss, if any. Remember, bank is liable to drawer only, not to any other person. What type of protection is available to paying bank? So a bank makes the payment and customer disputes that payment, then bank has to establish that payment was made in due course. This means bank can protect itself only if bank is able to prove, to establish that when the payment was made, the payment was made in due course. Let us see what is a payment in due course. So under Section 10 NI Act, payments are payments in due course if following conditions are satisfied. First condition, the payment is as per apparent tenor of the instrument. Second, payment is in good faith and without negligence. Third, payment is being made to the person who was in possession of the instrument. So first, the payment has been made as per apparent tenor. Apparent tenor means as per the instructions which appear on the instrument. and payment has been made in good faith. Good faith means when payment was made, at that time there was no circumstance which puts the bank in doubt that payment cannot be made to this person. If bank makes payment of those checks which are endorsed, so what type of protection is available for those checks? So which are endorsed? As per Section 85(1), bank is discharged when payment is made to the endorsee in a normal course. So if check is endorsed and payment is made to endorsee, not the endorser, in a normal course, then bank is discharged. If it is bearer check, then what type of protection is available? As per Section 85, subsection 2, bank will be discharged when payment is made to the bearer. So in case of endorsed check, bank is discharged when payment is made to endorsee in a normal course. In case of bearer checks, bank is discharged when payment is made to the bearer. Protection to paying bank for material alteration. As per Section 89, if a check is paid which has material alteration, the bank gets protection if alteration is not apparent and payment is made as per apparent tenor. So if alteration is not visible, even after proper examination of the check of the instrument, then bank will be discharged. Bank will not be liable under Section 89.